Hey, folks. I'm pausing. Go grab something warm to drink. It is... what, 51 degrees this morning in central Pennsylvania. I am going to read. I want to read a verse. Enjoy the worship music while it's playing. I've been experiencing something in my spirit. I didn't want to share too much of it for a few weeks now, but I'm really, it's really coming to the forefront of what God has been doing in me. And I notice how the demonic, how the cares of this world do try to get us off track, and how to try to get us persuaded that the things of God aren't as important. And I'm sensing, and I've had it for many years, and I think now that I'm in a place of repentance and asking the Lord to restore, as He's been so faithful and wonderful to do. I'm really sensing and feeling such a heavy, and for those of you pastors out there, I know you know what I'm trying to say. Such a heavy burden to minister God's word, and it is it is a thirst that I can't quench. And when I'm in God's word, it seems that I just cannot get enough. And when I open the word of the Lord, it's alive. And I can't explain it any more, any different. And the reason why I'm sharing this is because I know the message that I shared yesterday evening with many of you, about spending 10 minutes and getting on your knees and then spending time in God's presence. There's something about, the only way I can say it is that there's a heart condition. God knows that you're in love and that your desire is real. And I said many times before, we can't trick God. We can't trick our Lord. The Holy Spirit can't be fooled. And the true nature of a repentant heart, it does something to God. It really does create a place of favor, I don't know how else to share that, I'm trying to get some worship music up for you guys without losing focus here. But it seems like everything that I've been sharing for the last 8 months is like pieces of a puzzle. And I don't understand other than that. God's got a way of doing things that many of us can only receive from Him because of whatever issues that we have. And there really is that place in our relationship with God that if we're surrendered, His word becomes alive, and then God's favor comes upon us because the desires of our heart are towards Him. And it really is a relationship. And so I wanted to read again. I read this yesterday, and I wanted to read it again in 2 Chronicles 7:14. And I know that this verse is, it seems like a vague, it really seems like a vague word from the Lord. But it's not. It is a word to a particular people. And I'm going to read it in 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive them their sins and will heal their land. You see how that verse fits right into what I was just saying? My people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves. And if you pray and seek me, and if you repent from those things that have separated you from me, then will I hear when you call out my name. Then will my ear be toward you from heaven. And I will take care of all your needs. I will restore everything that was taken from you. I will build my name in you, and I will heal you. I wanted to do a video this morning about Trump, and I may do it later on. See my signs? These are the signs that my wife and I got from the Trump rally. So I put them on the wall. I think she's going to have a hard time with that because I've got a tack in the wall. But I'll be having a banner up there soon anyway. Last night, I played some worship music with the guitar for about 2.5 hours. My fingers are really sore, but I recorded some of it for YouTube, and I had such warfare with these videos last night. I did a video last night at 6 o'clock. And I couldn't get it uploaded until 10 o'clock for some reason it changed everything about my user account. God knows, I don't have any idea what happened. And I was absolutely beside myself. And I lost the video entirely. And as I was trying to figure out what was happening, I realized the video wasn't even saved. So I had about 25-30 minutes of worship music, and what I was basically doing was I was having some of the worship music play quietly in the background, and I was playing the guitar loud enough for you here, just to enjoy the worship music and maybe even sing along. But I wanted to, as I was doing the video, as I was setting up to do a video, I was just enjoying God's presence and getting ready to spend a little bit longer time in the Word this morning. And this Word that the Lord gave me really impressed on me. The Spirit of the Lord really impressed on me to share. And so, Pastor TC, if you're watching the video, it is Williamsport, Pennsylvania. Williamsport, Pennsylvania. Thank you for the encouraging words, Pastor. And I know, as far as me, I am very appreciative of the words and the encouragement that you release. And I have been praying for you and your wife and your children and the body there. And every day that I pray for you guys, I'm sensing such resistance against you where you're at. And I know that God is ministering to you and moves upon you and through you. And you are a man of faith. And God does minister to you because you give him the time to minister to you. And every time that I do lift you guys up, I keep sensing, and I think a lot of it has to do with the location that you're at and how the demonic has established itself in that community. And God has put you there because he wants the believers to come together and defy that and to resist the devil and to bring about the people that are in that community, that, you know, the Bible says about their eyes and their minds are being blinded, and that many folks in that community, in that area, the demonic has gotten their eyes blinded, and they may even, and there was one day that I was praying and I just saw like people walking right past the church, and they didn't even notice the church was there. And so I know that there's a lot of resistance in the spirit against what God has called you to do there. And so I've been praying in intercession for you folks. And so yeah, I just wanted to share that. Yeah. Thanks, Pastor. Everything sounded good with the audio and the video. Probably much better than what mine has been sounding like, and I guess we're still working on it. And so, but Yeah, just a quick video or a video that just something that the Lord's been has put on my heart this morning to share, maybe to clarify. It's an interesting thing to have. You know, when I talk about what God has called me to do in the mantle that is on me, I can almost sense and feel in my spirit the jealousy or the ha ha ha, listen to him. And I understand, I'm okay with that. And I know that what I know and what I perceive, and those of us that have a prophetic call, who have been schooled and have been trained in their understanding in the revelations, we perceive and know that God does minister to us differently and does give us the ability to enter in a way that is much different than I'm trying to find another song here for you folks. Hold on. I guess what I'm trying to say is this, that there's things that God has made known to us. What does the word say that when the people cry out, God raises up a prophet and sends, right? He raises up a voice and sends them a prophet. And what is it that is peculiar or different about a prophet? A prophet is somebody that has the gift of prophet, that is as called as a prophet, is much different than somebody that moves in the gifts of prophecy. And it's unfortunate that many people, even people that I know, who think that they are prophets aren't prophets, but in their actions and their lifestyle proves that they are not prophetic, but they do have a prophetic, experience prophetic gifts. With the gift of prophecy. And what happens is that there is a way, there is a perception that we have to discern and hear ways or God's voice because of our lifestyle or because of our laying down of our lives. And I liken, well, there's a different lifestyle from a person that is a prophet than a person that is not a prophet. And for those of you that call yourselves prophets, you can just look in the mirror and if you know of a prophet, try to see if there's any semblance in the way you live compared to the way that person lives. And in functions is the key. And there are things that we discern, and they're different because of being, if we're obedient, being so close to the Father, to the Father's heart and to his voice. And the Lord has made a lot of things known to those of us. And that's why in the earlier days I moved so wonderfully in the words of knowledge. And I would go in whatever it was that I was doing, God would just give me the word of knowledge. If it was intended for somebody particular that I was near, I would have that word of knowledge. And I don't move so much in the word of knowledge now. I think it was more so then to build my faith and to give me understanding of who I am in Christ, what God has put in me, and how I was formed before I, when I was in my mother's womb. So, I guess why I'm really going there is that I understand why I have this insatiable desire to speak God's word and to be so close and to go so deep. And I know that many of you don't have that. And that's why I inspire you, and that's why I provoke you. One, because I know that God is going to send young men and women with a prophetic call in their life, but have nobody to raise them up. And that was my problem. That was Morrow's problem. And if you believe or feel that you have a prophetic call and you have nowhere to go to be raised up, well, there's a place. But it's going to cost you every desire of your heart. And it's going to cause you to have to lay your life down. And there are things, impartations, there are things, not impartations, but revelations that God gives, and we'll reaffirm through this ministry for you, and we'll call you out and cause you to be challenged. And for those of you that are watching that don't understand, that those of you that have a prophetic call, if you can't receive the challenge from this one, if you can't receive, if you're so thin-skinned, you really are still at the milk stage of your process. And some of you, I would even question whether or not you have a prophetic call. But I don't know why I've gone off in this, other than my point is, as I'm talking, I'm really getting these leadings to say or to share, so I'm doing it. But my point is that I'm trying to keep the word very simple, and I'm trying to keep the provoking at a point where many can perceive and will receive and go deeper with God. And many a times that I do come across with a hard word, and I don't do it intentionally. I do as the Spirit of God leads. And so I do want to, I would rather just be somebody that encourages and somebody that causes you to go deep and to begin to, see, this thing is like ridiculous. And to begin to search for God like a treasure, to begin to do the things that you know God is wanting to do in you. And I'm trying to lower that. And gain an understanding. And to gain an understanding of what God is, I think I'm a little repetitive here, but to get understanding as to what God is trying to do with you. And so I wanted to share that a little bit this morning. And I did want to pray this morning with those of you that I realize many of you are working. It is Monday morning, and maybe some of you will catch this video in the afternoon. So for those of you that can and desire, if you don't want, you can shut me off. But we'll spend a few minutes, and I want to just I want to pray, and I have a little bit of a leading of some of the things I want to pray for this morning. And if these feel like that they are for you, receive them in Jesus' name. So Father, I just lift up the fellowship here, Father. Father, I lift up the ministry that you've called me to, Father. Father, I thank you for raising up the body, Father. Raising up those individuals, Father. And placing upon them, Father. Placing upon them, Father, a mantle. Many of you have already, God has already imparted, but the struggle to continue is very hard, it's very difficult. Whole covenant here, the Lord says, whole covenant here. And Father, I thank you for the leading, Father, for Pastor QC in the body. Father, I thank you for understanding. I thank you for leading, Father. I pray, Father, even those doors of revelation, understanding, Father, perception of the warfare that has been set against them, Father. Father, I just thank you for authority and dominion on Pastor TC. I thank you, Father, that you have equipped him. You have equipped many of us, Father, to pull down strongholds. Pull down strongholds, and that you have set us, Father, on a course of being schooled, sharpening our tools, Father, by the fast, by the quiet time, by the increase of them both, Father. You are sharpening our tools, Father. Father, I pray that you would cause that body there to unify, to become very strong in the season of resistance, Father. And Father, I thank you, Lord, that there are many a believer there, Father, in that city, in that community, that have thirsted for the knowledge of you. But the demonic has prevented them from even seeing and knowing what you have established in that city, in that community, Father. I pray, I just bind every power, every curse now in the name of Jesus by your blood. I break every curse against that body now in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you that you would send warring angels, Father, as even ministering angels, Father, to equip that body there, to equip Pastor, and give him the revelation as to what he needs to do and how he is to do it, Father. I thank you for the word that is inside of him, Father, and that is you, Jesus. Father, I thank you for the work that you're doing across this land. I thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. I praise your name. Jesus. Jesus. Yes, Father, even in this season, Father, you are drawing the body. You are bringing the body closer, Father. You are unifying the body. You are unifying the body, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. minister and touch, provide and care for every need of every believer here, Father, in Jesus' name.
Sometimes people get
confused. I give you praise for that, Father. I give you praise.
I feel like the Lord's all over.
In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, folks. And if you don't like those signs there, let me know.
Says now the tax collectors.
I'm not so sure I like them there either.
We're all gathering around to hear Jesus.
No, I don't want to make this a political thing and scare anybody away right away and not even have them stay and listen to the message that God has given.
Sets the stage and Jesus pipes up. He told them this parable.
For those of you that can and will, give me a comment what you think about those signs there. I don't mind taking them down.
The 99 in the open country.
I love you, Jesus loves you, and I will talk to you guys this evening. I'm going to do a video on what's going on with Trump and some leading that I've been getting about what's coming. And
I heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people.
I'm cautious as to what I'm supposed to share about that because
man, he's that good. I wanna just read.
There's a different sense when I get those revelations. There's a different sense about how I am to release it. So I have to be very careful. And I can't explain it other than I don't feel that release the same way that God gives a word of knowledge or some teaching. So I guess I have to be careful with some of the things I share. So anyway, I love you guys, and we'll see you later on. And I hope everything works easy with this video this morning. God bless you, folks.